My name is Casey Quinlan. I am the mighty mouth of Mighty Casey Media. And what I do is a really long list, but what I'll basically say is that I facilitate the festivus airing of grievances in healthcare. When it comes to fixing healthcare, I open with, "I got problems with you people," and then we go from there. I'm a patient activist. My first sort of qualifying event was watching my mother and her brothers fire my grandmother's doctor back in 1972, when that doctor had prescribed over 40 different medications to my grandmother all at the same time. No wonder she felt like hell. And once that happened, I sort of filed that away and thought, interesting. And then my mother had a rare pituitary brain tumor that was misdiagnosed for a long time. She had to be a self-advocate, and it got it resolved. My father had Parkinson's, later in life, but I sort of watched them be E patients, which was odd for people born in the 1920s. But as they aged, I needed to step up more and more with different issues that rose. And while I was being their sort of family care manager, I learned a lot about how to be able to get medical professionals to tell you what you need to know without any of that patting on the head or paternalism or data blocking. So my parents died at the end of 02. I got a 5-year break, and then I got a cancer diagnosis just before Christmas in 07. So I wrote a book called Cancer for Christmas about managing medical care based on my cancer treatment. And since then, I've been, I pivoted out of working in television as an engineer and producer, and I'm now a writer, speaker, general troublemaker in service of open data, open science, and patient empowerment. Patients are actually empowered, patients are engaged, but the system side isn't really paying enough attention. So I'm there to be as loud as possible to make sure that the system pays attention and we fix this thing, because damn it, it needs to be fixed. Well, my solution is participatory medicine, frankly, that the patient needs to be the primary CEO of the care team, and then all of the clinical professionals who work with the patient, work under the patient's guidance with, what their values are, what their preferences are, how they want their life to unfold, what they consider peak health performance. And I think that anyone who has had a medical issue, particularly a chronic one, or one like cancer, winds up becoming, at least to some degree, participatory, but coming to the system, which is definitely not wired for participation on the part of the patient, it's this tension that goes on. It's starting to change, but it's only when patients start to drive for this that the system will actually change, because the status quo, there's a lot of inertia in the status quo. And there's also, in the United States, $3.7 trillion behind the status quo. That's a couple bucks, in case you missed the memo. But the issue is the money, and trying to pull out some of that excess cash that's being spent on U.S. healthcare could do a lot for a lot of things, including education, infrastructure. That's why I do what I do. I want to pull the excess out and free up the cash to do better for people before they have to go to the hospital or go to the doctor or live in a neighborhood that has toxic waste. The list goes on. I met Dave DeBronkart online in 2009 and then IRL F2F in 2010. And that was right around the time that the Society for Participatory Medicine was forming as an organization. And I joined in 2010 and have been a member since, because I support the mission. And the best way to get this moved forward, as much as I have said patients need to take charge, we do need to come up with a collaboration across all of the stakeholder silos in healthcare, everything from patients to doctors to nurses to researchers to tech geeks to developers to business folks. We all need to work together to try to fix this. And the Society for Participatory Medicine is one of the few organizations I know of that actually has all of those stakeholders in its membership. And I mean, dude, it's only $50 a year. So come on, join the party, because we're actually making a difference and you can help.